Hello everybody, my name is Zohir Chaudhary and now we'll talk about natural source of ionizing radiation, and as an example we'll talk about radon. Before we can start our discussion on radon, we must understand the radioactive half-life. What is half-life? Radioactive half-life is the time it takes half the radioactive atoms present to decay. So for example, in here we have 16 atoms in here. From 16 you have 8, so half of them are gone. In the next radioactive half-life, from 8 you'll go to 4, in the next one from 4 to 2. And this is another example of radioactive half-life. It starts off at 100, after one half-life it is half of 150, and then in the second half-life is half of the second, which is 25, and then for the third half-life is half of this, 12.5, and so forth. So as you can see, it takes multiple half-lives for a radioactive product to start at, let's say, 100%, to go down to something close to zero. With that knowledge, we can start approaching this topic about radon. So what is radon? Radon is a colorless, odorless gas that is produced naturally by the decay of natural radioactive materials in the earth. Radon seeps into home through uranium-containing soil and in water from wells. Those are major sources of radon. And radon gas further decays into short-lived daughter products that attach to particles and can be deposited in the deep lung. So essentially, radon daughter products, they have very short half-lives, as we'll see later. When these decay, they cause radiation exposure to nearby lung tissues. It is estimated that 5 to 20,000 lung cancer deaths are caused by radon alone in the U.S. So that's a very large cause of lung cancer death in the U.S. And in the indoor air that comes from the soil is typically less than 1%. However, for houses with low indoor pressure and poorly sealed foundation, they may draw as much as 20% of their air from the soil. As you can see in here, radioactive isotopes from the soil, once it decays into radon, radon is a gas, so it slowly seeps up from the soil into the air, and as it seeps up, it can find cracks and pipes and progressively go into the basement or other tight spaces in our home and accumulate there. The uranium radioactive decay chain is shown in here. So from in the top you can see uranium-238, and which is undergoing alpha decay diagonally, beta decay horizontally in this reverse section, alpha, beta, alpha, beta, and alpha. So as it goes through alpha decay, uranium is becoming thorium, then to beta decay is becoming protactium, and then again to uranium-234. And this process continues until it reaches radon, or RN, in here. This process of radioactive decay is also shown in here with the name of all of these radioactive isotopes and the specific type of radiation that dominates, with the half-life of that process. And zooming in into radon radioactive decay, so once it reaches radon, within a very short time, it becomes polonium, and then lead, and then bismuth, and then polonium, and then again lead. In fact, from radon to lead, if you can take a look in here, there's multiple radioactive decay products, and in here it takes 3 minutes, 27 minutes, 20 minutes, less than a second, and then finally 20 years. And as all of this multiple radioactive decay happens, alpha, alpha, beta, and alpha are released, including some gamma as well. So the problem with radon, as we can see, that once radon accumulates in a basement, and we go to the basement, within a very short period of time, that radon can cause significant exposure to our lung tissue because of the very fast half-life of its daughter products. This map in the it shows different zones within the US and in California zoomed in, where radon exposure can be the highest in red, moderate in orange, and then low in yellow. In fact, most of California seems to have moderate to low, except Santa Barbara County. And in the US, it's mostly in the Midwest where high exposure of radon in the soil can happen. It is said that a 1,000 square foot house with 4 picocuries per liter of radon has nearly 2 million radon atoms decaying in it every minute. So the health effects from radon, it's similar to the alpha and beta health effects that we mentioned earlier. It poses significant internal damage with alpha. Beta poses both external damage as well as internal damage. And because of radon is a gas, it quickly goes inside our lung and is the number two leading cause of lung cancer after environmental tobacco smoke. In fact, almost 21,000 lung cancer deaths have been reported from radon every year in the U.S. So quick concept check. Which of the following factors affect an individual's exposure to radiation? D, all of the above. Why all of the above? Because as we just learned, geographical location, it's because of the natural exposure. Occupational, depending on whether in your occupation you may have radiation exposure, needs to be understood, as well as medical history, whether you've had significant x-rays or other types of radiation therapy. So all of the above is the answer. Another quick concept check, true or false. Radon is a natural source of radiation. True. All right, thank you.